Allora, oggi facciamo la seconda colonna. We start reviewing the thermodynamic properties that are left. So, after density and viscosity, we do a review of conductivity and surface tension. Cominciamo, we start with conductivity. That are not very much data. Ci mettete un attimo.
Yes. No.
Allora, in Aspen Plus, you have to select for thermal conductivity, the name is KL. Okay, try to use this data with care. Look carefully at the temperatures. Allora, these are data for the liquids. Okay. So, KL. If the pressure is not specified, it is 1 atmosphere. Dai, remember.
Scusate, voi sapete come faccio a convertire il file in Excel?
Ma è un foglio Excel.
Lo so, ma non me l'ha salvato come foglio Excel.
Quando Zoom non lo fa, devi segnalare tu il formato su Windows, quindi mettici un punto XLSX dovrebbe
Ah, così.
aprirtelo. Altrimenti prova ad
Ok,
aprirlo lo
grazie.
stesso con Excel.
No, no, mi è bastato aggiungere e adesso me lo apre. Perfetto, grazie mille.
No, è proprio un errore che fa Zoom, e se non te lo apre perché non lo riconosce. Vai tra.
Sì, la chat di Zoom è la cosa più farlocca di Zoom. Okay. This is, for example, thermal conductivity of benzene by Aspen Plus and by the experimental data. Ok, allora, per la cronaca, the thermal conductivity was taken from this article. Ok. Ci siete? Pronto?
One moment, please.
Una volta che avete finito le conduttività, avvisatemi che le tensioni superficiali ce le dividiamo. Grazie. Toluene is less accurate than benzene. Nevertheless, it's not so bad. Ok, etil benzene, ok. Allora, for etil benzene, I see if I find something here, because up to now I could not find anything. Ok, there is something here for styrene. Figure 1.13 for the liquid. Styrene monomer surface tension at, cosa me ne frega la surface tension? Styrene monomer thermal conductivity of saturated liquid. It's a line. I try to put into Aspen some data from this graphic. Quando avete finito avvisatemi,
Certo.
Lo styrene lo faccio io per tutti a sto punto. La temperatura è in centigradi, vediamo un po', 0 gradi, 1 e 22 in... calorie su ora, centimetro grado centigrado. Queste sono al secondo, quindi non va bene. Che schifo, non sa di misura. Calorie su ora centimetro grado centigrado. Allora. Calorie al centimetro. Calorie su ora, calorie al secondo, quindi devo dividere per 3600.
cosa dobbiamo fare oltre alle tre conduttività?
La tensione superficiale e i coefficienti di diffusione. Le tensioni superficiali dividetevele, non fatele tutte.
Ah, ok.
Io faccio... Vai tu benzene, io toluene allora.
Va bene.
Vado io letto il benzene.
Allora, 100 gradi invece 1,03. Speriamo bene.
La property per la tensione superficiale.
La trovi nel pacchetto transport, è l'ultima, SIGL.
Ok, grazie.
Niente. Allora, the conductivity for styrene is reproduced very well save at low temperatures. So it's okay. Because our process is at moderately high temperatures. We don't care about very low temperatures. Allora, the surface tensions are taken from this book. Surface tension of pure liquids and binary liquid mixtures. Allora, the unit of measure, Newton, millinewton, on meter, it's equivalent on dine on centimeters.
Okay.
I will pick up the mixture, benzene, toluene. You guys do the other four and let me know if there are problems.
No. No, for toluene it's okay. It's quite okay. Straight line.
Same for benzene.
Meno male.
La terza era diffusione.
Sì, per la diffusione adesso vediamo un attimo perché purtroppo i dati che ho trovato sono pochissimi, sono puntuali. E anche se in realtà il coefficiente di diffusione è un parametro piuttosto importante, però ecco perché non me la dà per le miscele. Nelle transport properties, me la dà in all. Vabbè.
Ah.
Ok. Dine on centimeters, ok. Evaluation.
Anche l'etil benzene va bene.
Perfetto. Mi aspetto, I expect that the mixture analysis, if benzene and toluene are reproduced correctly, as you say,
Stirene non va tanto bene invece.
Scusami?
Lo stirene non va tanto bene.
Allora, this is the mixture benzene toluene, not very good. Allora, the problem with the surface tension of the mixture is that Aspen Plus interpolates things linearly, while the real data are not so linear. You see? Yes. Nevertheless, we can notice that the interval of the value is very narrow. See? From 28.45 to 28.87. So, even if the values are not very correct, the interval is so narrow that it's not important. No, for stirene, vediamo un po'. Questo maledetto stirene, sempre non ci dà problemi. Hai provato a fare i coefficienti di diffusione, Simone?
Sì, li sto cercando adesso. Cioè no, sto cercando altra roba intanto, che aspettiamo.
Ah, su internet?
Sì.
Allora, Martina, if I use the data from the Yondel-Bessel guide, the interpolation is correct. Pronto, mi senti Martina?
Sì.
So, nevertheless, allora, the surface tension were taken from this book. Allora, the point is that this guide from Yondel-Bessel has is not the reference. So it is also possible that these values are calculated and not experimental. This book has many references. So for example, maybe the dataset used, the first one, was not the best. You see, for example, allora, Aspen Plus at 80 degrees predicts a surface tension of 28. Okay?
Okay.
In the first data set of this book, we have 24. In the second data set, we have 28.1. So you see that probably also the surface tension of styrene itself experimentally, it's not very easy to determine. You see, guys, two different authors, two sensibly different results.
Yes.
So we can go on with the results of Aspen Plus for the sake of simplicity. We found two references in accord with Aspen and one reference that disagree with Aspen. Okay? So for democracy, we are fine.
Sounds okay.
Mm. Che paraculo. Allora, i coefficienti, diffusion coefficient are very important, but unfortunately are not very easy to find in the literature. We can do a spot check. Because we have not much data. Benzene, toluene, tilbenzene ti dà il coefficiente di fusione in soluzione con chi?
Free solution immagino sia quello che dicevi te in...
con se stesso.
In se stessi.
E cosa c'è lì? Un 10 alla 9 metri quadri al secondo?
Per 10 alla 9 metri quadri sul secondo, sì.
Well, the values that I found, allora, the article was this... Allora, the order of magnitude is the same, good. But I have two from this paper where you have 1.16. From this paper.
Ah, 2.2. Ah sì, sono uguali quelli in aria, sono un po' sono diversi questi.
Yes, in air they are the same. For example, I can create a stream of pure benzene. Okay, now I get some results. Allora, these data are pretty close to the experimental ones. Especially for benzene. Toluene is less good. In your paper, Simone, how much is toluene?
It's... toluene 0.97.
Ah, 0.97.
Ma erano tutti più bassi, anche il benzene era 1.16.
Nevertheless, your paper was, our data were for toluene and benzene in themselves, not in the mixture.
Yes.
So for me, it's enough that the number are more or less in the proper range. Perché meglio di così.
Non sono nemmeno ancora sicuro che sia esattamente la stessa cosa questo.
Ok, no, for the properties we are done. To calculate rigorously the second column, we place another rad frac in the flow sheet, we connect with the additional stream and use a transfer block. So. Sì, esiste. Just remember that even before activating a transfer block between the feed streams, you have to specify something in the new feed stream. Otherwise, the program won't let you go on. There were some etilbenzene, some benzene, some toluene. It's not important that you remember exactly the quantities. Allora, I start making the transfer block, so before I forget it. Oh, and now the column. Allora, number of stages. Allora, ci siete fin qua?
Yes. Secondo.
Allora, it's not equilibrium, it's rate based. If we want to simulate a rate based tray column, it's not like in a rate based packet column, where the number of stage is just a theoretical calculation. Because you don't have stages in a packet column, you have the packing. So, if you specify the number of stages in a packet column, you just specify a number of equivalent theoretical equivalent trays to the packing. Via the number HETP, you remember. Now, these are actual stages. So, you have to have a first idea of how many stages have your column. Design the distillation column for separating benzene into toluene. So, a mixture pretty close to ours. Allora, you can start designing your column supposing that the trays are equilibrium trays. Otherwise, you get some reference and you put in the number of trays that you find in the reference. So, for example, this paper say that the equilibrium stages could be 14. Another reference that I found for a similar mixture. Ok, prescribes as much as 20 equilibrium stages. Okay, this is also for benzene and toluene. In any case, we already know that the, how to say, rate-based stage will be more than the equilibrium stages. So we can start putting inside the number from 15 to 20. Remember also that our actual task is to purify ethyl benzene. So I start writing 20. Remember also that we have the equilibrium column as a reference. Our equilibrium column run with 25 stages fed at the middle. So we can also replicate our original specification. Okay, any of these initial assumptions is good because working on the column will modify it. Oh, the condenser is a total condenser. As basic column specification, we can inherit the column specification from our original equilibrium column. So we had 0.8 of bottom to feed ratio and 5 reflux ratio. Okay, we can start feeding the column in the middle. The pressure, we copy that from our equilibrium columns. So 1.2 bar at the condenser. We don't specify the pressure drop because Aspen Plus will calculate it. Mm-hmm. We go to the column internals. Allora, from stage 2 to stage 24. Okay. Trade sieve. Allora, you see that Aspen Plus already start surmising that there will be 0.61 meters between each stage. Allora, this value is pretty close to those suggested by all the guides. Allora, for example, dov'è che era qua? Ok, for example, select plate distance 0.61 meters. Here in this other guy, you find ray spacing. Sì, dammi un numero, coglione. Ok, qui ve lo dà in pollici. Ray spacing large is 18 inches, so 18 divided 2.5, it's 18 per 2.5 it's 45 centimeters. So you see that the numbers are in range. Allora, to calculate the diameter, one has to make assumption on the vapor velocity. You should find a diameter, okay, such that the flow factor liquid to vapor is in the range to avoid whipping and flooding. So in theory, you should calculate. You should pick up the liquid and vapor flow from the equilibrium column. Multiply for the ratio of the viscosities is in square. Then find the K coefficient from this kind of graphics once you know the plate spacing. Once you have the coefficient, you estimate the flooding velocity. And you remember that usually Aspen Plus made the calculation at 80% flooding velocity. Allora, we can go for tentatively. For example, in this guide, you see that you have more or less between 1 and 3 square meters as a cross section in the column, but this depends very much to the feed. The main thing is that the velocity of the gas must be more or less 1 meter per second. So if you go to our old equilibrium column and you pick up the profiles, allora, flow rate, vapor e liquid. Allora, you see that the vapor flow is more or less constant. Allora, in cubic meter per hour, se ce lo dà, we have in normal cubic meter per hour, it's not the same, but allora, we have an average of 3000. If you want a velocity of 1 meter per second, from the fact that you have 3000 cubic meter per hour, you can find the area cross section. So 3000 cubic meter per hour, it's 0.3 cubic meter per second. So roughly your column must have a cross section of 0.84 square meters, approximately. So, also approximately, we can start by putting 1 square meter of tray diameter. Ok? Chiaro il ragionamento? I'm relying on the assumption of this guideline that 1 meter per second is a good vapor velocity. In the other guide, in this other guideline, I have column inner diameter 1.09. So, as you see, we are pretty close to our reference. Remember that this guide was made for a feed of 100 kmol per hour. We are pretty close to that value because our total feed is more or less 86. Ok. Adesso ti è più chiaro, Simone? Allora, notice that I relied on this assumption. This value can be calculated following this passage that you find in the books and in the theory. Allora, you saw that in our equilibrium column, if you assume that a vapor is always 1,000 times less dense than a liquid, then this square root means to divide by 30. Then you go to your equilibrium columns in Aspen Plus. Ok, here you have the liquid, here you have the vapor. Volumetric flows. Allora, in this section you have no, sì, ok. Liquid divided by vapor is more or less one. In this other section, liquid divided by vapor is 1.5. So in the fourth section, this ratio is 1 divided by 30. In the other, it's 1.5 divided by 30. So roughly, you are between 0.03 and 0.02. Okay? We are here. From this correlation, you can find the K factor, and the K factor you use to find the velocity. If you have a K factor of 0.1, then you have rho liquid divided rho vapor minus 1. This square ratio is roughly 30, and then we find 3. So more than 1. Nevertheless, we could find also lower diameter. But I will let Aspen Plus to carry out all this additional calculation. I just needed a forced guess for the column diameter. This is the point. C'è più chiaro adesso?
Sì, intanto poi il diametro lo correggiamo
Adesso,
in base ai risultati.
esatto, i calcoli dettagliati ce li facciamo fare da lui. Allora,
È solo per avere uno starting value onesto,
è
per fare
solo per
i
avere uno starting
calcoli.
value onesto, bravo. Ora vedi che allora, si trace. Ok. Now we also have to provide reasonable guess also for the tray itself. Allora. Ok, allora, whole diameter, tray type, and so on. Allora, we can refer to this guide once again. We found hole size, for example, 5 mm. The range is from 2 to 12. And we see that Aspen starts with the higher values, 12. So, we try leaving the default because it is in the recommended range. The pitch should be 2.5 to 4 times the whole diameter. Nevertheless, what is more important than the pitch, that Aspen can calculate the pitch by itself, allora, is this parameter. Ok, whole area 10% of active area. You find this parameter right here. Allora, qua non tocchiamo niente, ma mi interessa che abbiate capito. Both these guides are made using this book. Mm-hmm. Allora, from page 500 on, you find all the correlation and the explanation. Sì?
Yes.
With all the recommended values and stuff. Plate hydraulic design and so. Allora, here you will find a lot of starting guesses for your values. Active area, for example, these are reasonable values. Allora, weird dimension and so on. Allora, you see in this guide, now, this is a view from the top, and this is the cross-sectional view of your train. Okay. Allora, how can we put reasonable guesses for these values? Okay, allora, if we refer to this guide, we have, for example, wheel height 50 millimeters. So, if you don't find all the values in a reference, you can try putting your guess and let Aspen do the work. So, for example, down comer area 0.11. Nevertheless, allora, the down comer area should be 12% of column area. So, you should have a down comer of 0.1 square meters. So, you must regulate this thickness to have a 0.1 square meter of grayed out zone. Allora. Ok. If I leave some number blank, Aspen Plus will calculate some values for the defaults. Ok?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Allora. For now, here, I don't need the clearance because I have the spacing. And I don't need the wheel length because as default can be the same as the downcomer. In this other guide, for example, I have HOV, that HOV is this number, guys. Allora, HOV. 2 centimeters. And it is the spacing minus the clearance. Okay. O meglio, the spacing minus the wheel length, the wheel height. So 60, 50, the remaining should be 2. I have 10. Nevertheless, if something is wrong with the specification, Aspen Plus will tell you. Allora, We just have to specify that the calculation is rate based, and in any tray the vapor phase are well mixed. Allora, this option is good if you don't have the down cover. Counter current is not for our case because there is a good mixing in a seed tray. Liquid phase mixed, vapor is plug flow. I don't know. For first instance, I will leave mixed.
Okay.
The preferred option are mixed or current. Allora, we don't have reactions. We have film. Per carry. Design mode to calculate column diameter. Allora, remember that from the equilibrium column, the vapor flow was higher on the top section. So base stage, let's put, for example, 5. Flood velocity, 0.8. This means that we will move 0.8, means that we are on this curve. The entrainment, guys, is the parameter that discriminates between weeping and flooding. Physically, the entrainment depends on the surface tension. That's why I made you review the surface tension of our substances. Okay, we see if Aspen needs something like I also forget one thing. This parameter determines the thickness of the plate. Allora, in this guide, the suggested thickness is vediamo se c'è scritto the thickness. No, non c'è scritto. Ah, plate thickness 5 mm for carbon steel, 3 mm for stainless steel. Aspen Plus suggests by default 3.4 mm. Ok. So if Aspen let us go, we can try.
Cosa abbiamo messo in sections?
Jet flooding column exceed 80%. Ok. So probably the diameter is too small. I look at the geometry results. The calculated diameter is 90 centimeters. So I have a relatively large diameter. So I look at the hydraulic plots. Okay. So I have a flooding before the feed trays. See, guys? What does it mean, flooding? It means that the vapor flow is so high that the liquid cannot go down. Mi seguite?
Mm-hmm.
So, I could increase the hole size or increase the column diameter. You could also look at the suggestion of Aspen Plus. Stage 21 has a very high pressure drop. Stage 21 is operating above 100% downcomer choke flood. So, another possibility is that the column diameter is good, but the downcomer is choked. So, the downcomer is too small. So, I can try many things to correct the result. Allora, I have 1 meter of diameter and Aspen Plus calculated 0.9 meter. So, probably I will try to fix the hydraulics from the downcomer. Questo dipende anche dai messaggi di errori che ricevete voi, eh? Perché se non ne ricevete. Allora. I have too much entrainment. Allora, I can try specify the downcomer in the opposite direction before increasing the diameter. Allora, you see, it's a tentative procedure. Okay, yeah, no worry. Trade columns are like this. We have the other hydraulic plots that help us. We have problems under the feed. Okay, because over the feed there are no problems. Allora, you see that if you pick the profile, okay, we have a very high liquid flow under the feed, and so there are more problems under the feed. Allora, probably this column should be divided in two. So I'm feeding it at 12. So probably bisogna far così, ragazzi. Allora, this specification for this section is good enough above the feed. So, in, add new. No. Okay. Allora, if you go with interactive sizing in the second column, Aspen will do such job in your stead.
Yes.
Allora, the option in threading sizing is available only if you have one more column section or only if you already have run a simulation beforehand. Allora, you see that our guess for the VIR 8 was good enough. Our guess for the downcomer, not very much. So Aspen, for example, is calculating a higher downcomer width for the lower section. Nevertheless, the only answer is to run the simulation and see what we get. So in this case, you see that if the bottom section has higher diameter and a higher downcomer, the column is in range. We have only a problem at the feed tray because I included the feed tray in the upper section while it should operate better with the parameters of the lower section. So, okay, I try to do like this, and I look again the hydraulic plots. No, the hydraulic plots are all good. The basic column calculation is done. Yeah. If the hydraulic plots are good, you have 90% probability that everything else is good. If something is wrong, you will have a wrong hydraulic plots. You get the meaning? Any error will become a wrong hydraulic plots. Viceversa, good hydraulic plots gives you 90% probability that you didn't make errors or big errors. Allora, if you look at the results, you have a pressure drop of 0.08 bar for the upper section and 0.11 bar for the lower section. Allora, to update the pressure drop in the column, guys, you have to switch in rating mode for both the section. Because now the parameters for the second section are calculated correctly by Aspen. If you make rerun the simulation, now you can have your columns with the updated pressure profile. Okay. Now we can check the column performance. Allora, if you remember, the task of the column was to recover as much ethyl benzene as possible. We have designed the equilibrium column to recover 0.975 of ethyl benzene, and we had a purity of 97%. Now let's see how the rigorously calculated column is working. Allora, the recovery is high. I have 68 moles divided 69.6. It is 98% recovery. The purity is 97%. So the rate-based column is already operating very satisfactorily.